What defines the primary purpose of the EUI Act? A. To provide financial support for AI startups in Europe. B. To establish Europe as the leading developer of AI technologies. C. To ensure that AI systems respect fundamental rights, safety, and ethical principles. D. To ban all AI systems considered a threat to privacy. Correct answer. C. To ensure that AI systems respect fundamental rights, safety, and ethical principles. Which of the following AI systems would be classified under unacceptable risk, according to the EUI Act? A. AI-powered educational software. B. AI in autonomous vehicles. C. Social scoring systems implemented by governments. D. AI for spam detection in email services. Correct answer. C. Social scoring systems implemented by governments. What is required for high-risk AI systems before they can be deployed according to the AI Act? A. A formal approval by the CEO of the deploying company. B. A public vote of support from EU citizens. C. Strict adherence to open source software principles. D. Adequate risk assessment and mitigation systems. Correct answer. D. Adequate risk assessment and mitigation systems. Which sector is specifically mentioned as an example of using high-risk AI systems in the EUI Act? A. Social media content curation. B. Employment, particularly CV sorting software for recruitment procedures. C. Video game development. D. Personal fitness and health tracking. Correct answer. B. Employment, particularly CV sorting software for recruitment procedures. A tech startup is developing an AI system for evaluating job applicants' resumes for companies. This AI system ranks candidates based on their qualifications, work experience, and a proprietary algorithm that predicts job performance. What obligation does this startup have under the EUI Act before deploying this AI system? A. Ensure the AI system is only used by companies outside the EU. B. Publish the algorithm's code on a public repository for transparency. C. Conduct an adequate risk assessment and implement mitigation systems. D. Receive explicit consent from all job applicants before processing their resumes. Correct answer. C. Conduct an adequate risk assessment and implement mitigation systems. An AI system has been developed for remote biometric identification in publicly accessible spaces, aiming to enhance security measures. The system is capable of identifying individuals in real time from surveillance camera feeds. Under what conditions can this AI system be legally deployed according to the EUI Act? A. In any situation as long as there is a public notification about its use. B. Without restrictions, given the importance of public security. C. Only in narrow exceptions, such as preventing a specific and imminent terrorist threat. D. After a public referendum approving its use. Correct answer. C. Only in narrow exceptions, such as preventing a specific and imminent terrorist threat. A public university is introducing an AI-based system to score exams and assignments, determining students' grades and potentially their future academic opportunities. How is this AI system classified under the EUI Act, and what does this classification entail? A. High risk, subjecting it to strict obligations like high-quality datasets and human oversight. B. Minimal or no risk, allowing for its use without specific obligations. C. Limited risk, requiring specific transparency obligations. D. Unacceptable risk, leading to an outright ban of the system. Correct answer. A. High risk, subjecting it to strict obligations like high-quality datasets and human oversight. A company develops an AI chatbot that provides mental health advice to users. The chatbot interacts with users through text, offering personalized suggestions based on their input. According to the EUI Act, what requirement must the company meet regarding this AI system? A. Register the AI system as a medical device. B. Ensure the AI chatbot operates under the supervision of licensed psychologists. C. Inform users that they are interacting with a machine. D. Ban the system due to the sensitive nature of health advice. Correct answer. C. Inform users that they are interacting with a machine. An AI solution for managing visa applications automates the process of evaluating and approving applications for entry into an EU country. This AI system categorizes applications based on risk factors and recommends approvals or denials. Given its application, how does the EUI Act classify this AI system, and what are the implications? A. Minimal or no risk, allowing widespread use with no specific obligations. B. Limited risk, necessitating transparency about AI involvement to applicants. C. High risk, requiring a detailed documentation and adequate human oversight. D. Unacceptable risk, resulting in an immediate prohibition of its use. Correct answer. C. High risk, requiring a detailed documentation and adequate human oversight. An AI system designed for robot-assisted surgery offers real-time recommendations to surgeons based on medical images, patient data, and surgical procedures outcomes. Considering its critical application, what is expected from this AI system under the EUI Act? A. certification by a medical board before it can be used in surgeries, B, strict obligations such as adequate risk assessment and high-quality datasets, C, a trial period in non-EU countries before approval for use in the EU, D, mandatory co-development with a government health agency. Correct answer, B, strict obligations such as adequate risk assessment and high-quality datasets. An AI-powered platform for credit scoring uses personal financial data to determine individuals' creditworthiness, affecting their ability to obtain loans. This platform operates across the EU. According to the AI Act, what measures must be taken for such an AI system? A. The platform must exclude citizens of certain countries to reduce bias. B. It is classified as high risk, necessitating measures like activity logging and clear information to deploys. C. Only aggregate data should be used to avoid personal data processing. D. The system must be available for public use without any restrictions. Correct answer, B. It is classified as high risk, necessitating measures like activity logging and clear information to deployers. According to the EUI Act, what is required of AI systems that constitute a limited risk? A. Complete ban from the EU market. B. Specific transparency obligations to inform users. C. Mandatory alignment with GDPR. D. Yearly audits by independent AI ethics committees. Correct answer, B. Specific transparency obligations to inform users. How does the EUI Act classify AI systems that encourage dangerous behavior in toys using voice assistants? A. Minimal or no risk. B. Limited risk. C. High risk. D. Unacceptable risk. Correct answer, D. Unacceptable risk. What is the role of the European AI Office as established by the EUI Act? A. To provide financial grants to AI research projects. B. To oversee the AI Act's enforcement and implementation with member states. C. To develop AI systems for use in EU institutions. D. To negotiate AI regulations with non-EU countries. Correct answer, B. To oversee the AI Act's enforcement and implementation with member states. Under what conditions can the use of remote biometric identification in publicly accessible spaces for law enforcement be allowed according to the AI Act? A. Only with the explicit consent of all individuals being scanned. B. In any situation deemed necessary by local law enforcement. C. Narrow exceptions such as to prevent specific and imminent terrorist threats. D. Without restrictions, as long as data is handled confidentially. Correct answer, C. Narrow exceptions such as to prevent specific and imminent terrorist threats. What does the AI Act stipulate for AI systems under the category of minimal or no risk? A. They are banned unless approved by a special EU commission. B. They are subject to the same strict obligations as high-risk AI systems. C. The deployment is allowed without specific obligations but with general compliance to ethical standards. D. They must be disclosed to the public and open for comments before deployment. Correct answer, C. The deployment is allowed without specific obligations but with general compliance to ethical standards. The EUI Act introduces obligations for providers of general-purpose AI models, including A. Mandatory sharing of proprietary algorithms with EU authorities. B. Transparency obligations and additional risk management for impactful models. C. A requirement to donate a percentage of profits to AI safety research. D. A ban on exporting AI technology outside the EU. Correct answer, B. Transparency obligations and additional risk management for impactful models.